Guten Tag and welcome to the Saxon Ring, round 7 of MotoGP in 2023. It's the German Grand Prix and unfortunately the rain has arrived. It did for, about 5 minutes during MotoGP P1 as Jorge Martin just walks past. Let me just see if I can grab a very quick word with him before he goes. Oh, he's gone. Oh well, we tried. Anyway, yeah, the rain is falling, so could well be that this afternoon's P2 is maybe a little bit uneventful. Fastest is actually Johann Zarco ahead of Matt Marquez and Aleix Espargaró. Aleix Espargaró suffering a crash but went back out on bike 2 to be able to take third overall. And it's time for the Motul Superfan giveaway. The golden pass is up for grabs. Basically, let me bring you up to speed of exactly how it works. We're here down at Pramac with our two contestants. We'll get to them in a second. On Thursday, Jorge Martin went out and about and hid two separate golden passes. It was promoted on MotoGP's Instagram, so you can follow the stories there to see when they've been hidden. And then a couple of fans went around to manage to find them. And that means that they are now going to go head-to-head, one-on-one, to try and become the golden pass. I've been told that you have the golden pass from yesterday, so this is what they're fighting for. Where did you find it?
In the pit lane. I found it in the pit lane.
Very nice. So this is what you're looking out for. We're going to be doing this in Assen as well in a week's time. So on Thursday in Assen, either Johan or Jorge will be hiding these, and it's your job to try and find it. So well done. But this is absolutely useless now. Because we're trying to get you the golden pass, the golden ticket for the weekend. So, hello, how are you? What's your name?
My name is Shari. I'm fine, yeah.
And who are you supporting this weekend?
Different drivers. Mark, Jorge, Tony, Fermin.
Ah, oh, plenty. Well, good start anyway. And hello, how are you, sir?
Hello, I'm Tony. I want to say hello to my wife and my son. Hello, Eddie. Hello, Steffi.
Hello, Eddie. Hello, Steffi. Supporting KTM?
Yeah, I support Jack.
Just Jack in particular?
Brett is okay also.
But mainly Jack. Well, good luck to the pair of you. We've got three questions each. Before we started, Claudia, my glamorous assistant, whose birthday it is as well, happy birthday Claudia, did a toss of the coin to decide who's going to go first. And Tony, I believe you won that, correct? So here we go. First question to you, three questions each. Number one, the Saxon Ring is known for being a left-handed circuit, but how many left-handed corners are there? Is it A, 13, B, 10, or C, 9?
C, 9.
Sorry, it's B, 10. So, Sherry, an opportunity to try and take an early lead. The Saxon Ring is the shortest circuit in the championship, but how long is it? Is it A, 3 kilometres, B, 3.4, or C, 3.7?
I would say C.
Correct. 1-0. Well done. So, Tony, no pressure. You need to try and catch up here. Next one. Last year, Motul rider Johann Zarco, the man fastest in P1, stood on the podium here at the German Grand Prix. But where did he finish? Was he first, second, or third?
First.
He was second. It was Fabio Quartararo that won. So, here we go. Big opportunity. This is actually to win it nice and early. In 2022, Motul rider Jorge Martin broke the top speed record at this circuit. Not the overall top speed record, but fastest at the Saxon Ring. But what speed did he reach? Was it A, 304.2 kilometres an hour? B, 312.2, or C, 320.2? I'll give you them again. 304.2. Oh.
A.
Well done. It is A. 2-0. Job done. I mean, congrats, you've won. We'll do the three anyway, just to make sure. We'll try and get you on the board, Tony. Saxon Ring in 2014, a memorable one. Lots of riders in pit lane, starting the race from there with the rain coming down. But how many riders managed to stay on track and see the checkered flag? Was it A, 4, B, 7, or C, 9?
C, 9.
Well done, Tony. We've got one on the board. It's 2-1. Unfortunately, we do have a commiseration prize for you. This is for the clean sweep. So far, Matt Marquez is the rider with the most victories at this track. But who has taken the most pole positions at this track? Is it Valentino Rossi, Casey Stoner, or Marc Marquez?
Valentino Rossi?
It's not. It's Marc Marquez. But it doesn't matter. Well done. You are our super fan winner, courtesy of Motul. Do we have the prizes? Here we go. So, congratulations. This is for you. A bag full of goodies. And you're going to spend the weekend access all areas here in the paddock. How exciting is that?
Mega. Mega excited.
So, trying to get a look at Jorge Martin and Marc Marquez as well. You're going to have the opportunity to.
Thank you.
Congratulations, congratulations. Tony, commiserations. We've got small prize for you as well.
Yeah, thank you.
You can swap your KTM cap for a MotoGP one, but we'll allow you rest of the day. Enjoy it here in the paddock. Pop up to KTM, see if you can get a look at Jack.
Thank you very much. I had bad luck, but it was awesome.
Absolutely. Great to have you. Congratulations to both of you. Well done. And as we said, we'll be back for Motul Superfan this time next week. See you later, guys. Well done. So, as we said, Thursday, if you're in pit lane, you're out and about in the paddock at Assen, then have a look for them golden tickets. And you could well be winning an Access All Areas golden pass, courtesy of Motul. So, well done to Charlene. Was it Charlene? I think it was. Congratulations to her. Big win. Hello, how are we, gents? Like the T-shirt? Big Giacomo Agostini fan?
Yes. Geburtstag, no?
Sorry, my German isn't great.
Geburtstag heute.
The legend, the goat.
Hat Geburtstag, birthday.
It's his birthday. Is it really?
Giacomo.
Is it his birthday today?
Yeah, genau.
Happy birthday, Giacomo. Oh, thank you. I didn't know that. Giacomo Agostini's birthday, apparently. So, happy birthday, Giacomo Agostini. What is it? Tanti Aguri, I think they say in Italian. So, yeah, well done, Giacomo. If you're at home and you're watching inside the paddock, he was a guest in Le Mans, actually, for the 1000th Grand Prix. We saw him with the little glasses on, enjoying it. Was Giacomo Agostini. So yeah, happy birthday to him. Right, we're going to have a wander up and down pit lane. We see Marco Bezzecchi just going up the stairs there. He gives us a wave, but yeah, he's pretty busy, so we're not going to dive in. And we will just poke our head through a couple of the garages to see if we can find someone to have a quick conversation with. I was hoping to speak to someone from the Aleix Espargaró camp, but unfortunately, as a result of that crash in the opening 15, 20 minutes or so of MotoGP P1, he was unable to, the team are working away. Chele, can I grab you very quickly?
Yep.
How are you?
Not so bad. The weather is not so good, but...
No, it could be better. How was the opening practice?
Not so bad. We start struggling a bit with the hard tire, but I think it's not the correct choice for this weekend because it's a bit cold. So with the other one better, we have to work a lot, but we still improve forward.
I love these sunglasses, by the way. Are they custom? Because they fit the team perfectly.
I like it. Nice. I like a lot.
Are they custom or are they just...
No. The Oakley, the Walter Giannini, the Oakley man, sent to me to Mugello, I think, for the color of the team. A good one. I like it.
They look nice. But hopefully you need them tomorrow. At the moment, they're not much use.
At the moment, no.
Thank you. Chele, thank you. Nice to chat with him. Moto 2 star Celestino Vietti. So you see the Yamaha camp here. Some slightly glum faces down in Yamaha because both Frankie Morbidelli crashed just at the top of the waterfall at the Ralph Waldman curve. Fast one for him. And then about 60 seconds later, Fabio Quartararo went down as well at turn one. So you can see the team on the phones at the moment. Just checking everything is okay. I think Frankie did head to the medical centre just for some precautionary checks because it was a fast one for the Italian. Fabio Quartararo was up on his feet straight away though, which is good news. But plenty of work in both sides of the Yamaha garage after the slightly chaotic conclusion to MotoGP Practice 1 for the boys in blue. Aprilia Racing, as we said, Aleix Espargaró, despite two broken bones in the heel, was up inside the top three, but did crash as Ayagura comes speeding past. We're not going to grab him, unfortunately. It is a quiet paddock here. In fact, let's just head down Aprilia way, just in case we can grab someone. Being a little bit nosy here, but doesn't matter. Special helmet for Maverick this weekend as well. The Flash film is out in cinemas now, I believe, and he's got a special replica helmet to celebrate that. As we look up and down just to see if there's anyone in particular. No, it's pretty quiet at the moment, isn't it? Deary me, look at that down there. Normally, when we come into pit lane or into the paddock, we hope that there's a few people about. It's absolutely deserted. Right, let's go this way. We might be able to find someone. I'll bob my head in here. Anyone? No. So I could tell you about R&F Racing instead. Miguel Oliveira and Ralph Fernandez, of course, back to full strength. Ralph Fernandez, get this, in the race last time out in Mugello, actually threw up in his helmet during the Grand Prix, was having a strong ride and wasn't a million miles away. But then, obviously, just feeling a little bit under the weather. He wasn't sleeping well, wasn't able to take any food on board, and then in the end, unfortunately, threw up in the race, whereas Miguel Oliveira crashed out. Not what he needed, given the fact that he's looking to make an injury return from the shoulder injury that put him out of action following the Spanish Grand Prix. They're coming together with Fabio Quartararo as we're down here at the KTM. Jesse, how are you, mate? All good. Not much going on again. God, it's a bit quiet. It really is quiet. Nobody wants to speak. I think it's because of the rain. We're a bit stuck here. Right, let's go back the other way. We might be able to find someone. Let's see if we can spot a press officer who can help me out and grab someone. In fact, hello. How are you guys? All good?
Fine, thank you.
Enjoying the weekend?
Yes, rainy, but enjoy anyway.
Here with KTM, I'm guessing?
We are waiting for riders.
Jack or Brad?
Both.
Both, okay. Enjoy. Of course. Have they come out yet? No? Francesco. Here we go. Francesco, I'm struggling here at the moment.
He's a liar. He's not waiting for Ryder. He's waiting for me.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. He's a designer. Yeah, no. He's a designer. Starline Design.
Ah, okay. For the helmets. Okay. Oh, he's a bit of a...
Helmet and not only.
He's a celebrity then.
All the special edition and fairing painter. But he's one of the head of Starline, so... Yeah, he's not waiting for riders, he's waiting for me.
A paddock celebrity. Before I let you go.
He's also a friend, of course.
Before I let you go, how was that?
Wet. Partly wet. So, yeah, strange, very strange practice this morning with rain in the middle. And maybe in the afternoon will be heavier. So, yeah, nothing to do maybe today.
In terms of the KTM here, myself and Simon in the preview yesterday, just speculating, obviously, with it so different this year, is it going to be a circuit that suits it from early indications? What do you think?
Yeah, we still have to learn quite a lot around this bike. So, as I said before, the three races, Mugello here and Assen, we will know more at the end of the three races. The feeling this morning wasn't bad, but lack of grip. It was the comment. And after 15 minutes of rain and then 15 minutes to the end, out again. Strange, but same for everybody. We try to get the best out of today somehow.
Good luck. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'll let you go chat with your friends. You see. He was telling us a little white lie, trying to say he was here for Jack. Anyway, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Nice to meet you. I'm a fan of your work. And we've got Brad here as well. Let me just grab a quick chat with Brad. Star of the MotoGP podcast yesterday. Quick signature in the programme. Right colour pen as well.
Good, perfect.
How was the podcast yesterday? I was just saying you were the star of the show.
Well, I was the only one there. No, it was pretty good. Everything's so far so good. This little drizzle is a little bit annoying. Got a bit in the way earlier, but let's see. Meant to be a bit wet later.
Yeah, apparently it's going to get a little bit heavier, which isn't good news.
No, I mean, obviously with the sprint race tomorrow already, you want to do a few more laps to make sure you have the pace together. But it is what it is. Didn't feel bad this morning, and I'm pretty sure we can do a good job.
Cheers, Brad.
Shot, bud.
Thank you, mate. There we go. A KTM heavy, KTM influenced inside the paddock. We'll walk back down in this direction then, just before we round off to see if there is anyone else that we can grab a word with. There's Jonas Folger here, actually. Home GP. Let's grab a quick word with Jonas, shall we? We'll see. We've struck gold right at the end. Patience paying off as Jonas signs a few... what is that? The Tech Twi Yamaha from years ago in pristine condition as well. Look at that. Fantastic. Straight back in the box. Value has just gone through the roof there. The German fans often pretty good at having their collectibles. This gentleman to the right as well is just getting his old photos out as well. Where's he got here? The photos from... What year is that? What year are we talking there, Jonas? Oh, that would have been at the start of the year, from Sepang.
That was last year even, in August.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah, I started last year in August to test with KTM, so I'm not sure. Can be also this year.
Of course. Yeah. Very quickly, yes. Home Grand Prix, how was that? Did you enjoy it out there?
Amazing. It's a great feeling to be back, you know, after, how long is it, 6 years? Yeah, 17. So it's really nice to see all the fans, and it's a great feeling, great sensation. Track's beautiful. Of course, the weather is mixed conditions, but yeah, I like this track, so I try to close the gap compared to the last races. So yeah, enjoy it.
Enjoy. Good luck.
Yes, thank you.
100,000 people here on Sunday. All be cheering for Jonas. German flags are going to be here, there, and everywhere. As we wandered down one last time, just to see if we can grab someone else. And look at this. This is like, what's the film with Leonardo DiCaprio? I can't remember. But we're kind of just crossing paths at the moment as well. This is, it's like the Spider-Man meme. Hola, ¿qué tal? Follow us live on MotoGP's YouTube. Good luck. Trying to steal some viewers away from DAZN. Maybe we did a good job. Let's see. We'll see if our viewer count's going through the roof now. That's thanks to nicking a few from Isaskun. Right, one last wander down and then we'll wrap it up then, because I think we're about done. I need to go grab some lunch ahead of Moto3 P2, which is coming up, although it might not be the most eventful Moto3 P2 that we've ever seen. Work continuing here down at Yamaha, as we said, after a couple of crashes for Fabio Quartararo and Frankie Morbidelli for Gresini Racing. Alex Marquez was up there, he was competitive. But the star man, of course, is Marc Marquez. 602 days. That's how long it will be on Sunday since he last stood on the top step of the podium. Will he be able to do it? Or, given the fact who was fastest in practice one, will it in fact be Johann Zarco? I don't have that number on the top of my head the last time he was victorious, but we're talking thousands and thousands of days for Johann Zarco. Is this weekend finally it? Is he eventually going to stand on the top step of the podium in the Premier class? I mean, he's been on pole here in 21, finished second here last year, so I won't want to bet against it. Marc Marquez, the man to beat, but maybe Johann Zarco is the ultimate dark horse and he's going to charge through and shock us all. Fastest this morning, if the rain continues, he'll be fastest tonight as well. Thank you very much for joining us. Remember, tune in to Inside the Paddock next week. I'm just down here very quickly before you say goodbye. And Motul Superfan, it's in Assen, so on Thursday, try find the golden tickets. Right, now I'm done. Cheers, bye.